missing link. Folklore or myth, tell me what you think. When you're in the forest and your senses come alive, you can smell his presence in the blink of an eye. Bigfoot, Sasquatch back in the woods, Bigfoot, Yeti neighborhood, Bigfoot skunk ape, busy beast or man, Bigfoot Wendigo living off the land. Out in the mountains where the wild only walk, you can find a footprint that won't fit a sock. Crying in the night, is all you see. You might hear a grunt, some knocking on some trees. Bigfoot, Sasquatch back in the woods, Bigfoot, Yeti in your neighborhood, Bigfoot, skunk ape, busy beast or man, Bigfoot, Wendigo living off the land. Some people have spotted him every now and then. You never know if he's lurking just around the bend. He stands about 8 foot tall with big red eyes. Is he an animal or just a guy in a very scary, hairy disguise? Bigfoot, Sasquatch back in the woods, Bigfoot, Yeti in your neighborhood, Bigfoot, skunk ape, busy beast or man, Bigfoot, Wendigo living off the land. Searching for Bigfoots, searching for Bigfoots, searching for Bigfoots, searching. Bigfoot, Sasquatch back in the woods, Bigfoot, Yeti in your neighborhood, Bigfoot, skunk ape, busy beast or man, Bigfoot, Wendigo living off the land.
Okay, Jack Evans here with you this evening, and boy, this is going to be one wild controversial show this evening. Look forward to talking to this gentleman I have on the line this evening, and I'm going to bring him in right now, and it's Rick Dyer. Rick, thank you so much for coming on the show this evening.
Hey, man, thank you for having me.
And with us is Walter Shrum also, and Harry Metz in the studio taping tonight's show. They're going to put it on YouTube a little bit, maybe later this evening or tomorrow sometime. But the reason why, go ahead, Walter, the reason why we're taping this.
What's that?
Why don't you tell the listeners why we're Harry's here taping this tonight?
He's just going to tape it for Facebook or YouTube, a little bit of publicity, show the Pittsburgh area here, show the people outside the area, this WM, or one of our music stations here, right here in our community, WMBS Radio.
And really, to put it on the air, because Rick Dyer is the master Bigfoot tracker, and he's claiming that he has, well, he has killed Bigfoot. Is that correct, Rick?
That is correct.
And that was about, a year ago?
It was over a year ago.
Okay, and you have, where are you at tonight, Rick?
Right now I'm in Las Vegas, Nevada, gearing up for our tour that will start on Monday in Phoenix, Arizona.
Okay, and hopefully you're going to be able to swing by here in Pittsburgh area, Fayette County.
I will, if we can get a place booked there and get some sponsors there, then yeah, we will definitely come there. But our tour is basically booked, man, from Phoenix all the way over into Florida.
Wow. And for the listeners, Rick, in case they missed it, What are you going on tour about?
I'm going to carry the specimen of Bigfoot all over the United States and into Canada. And also, we've got a contract to go to Germany and Japan.
Wow. And Rick, where did you kill Bigfoot at? Well, how did you set this up? How long were you tracking Bigfoot? How did you know that it was in this area? And
well, the thing is that it's more than one, and I will go into that story a little bit later, and when that. The second one is going to be released. I'm not offering a piece of bear meat or a DNA sample. I've got the corpse of Bigfoot. And I got the corpse of a smaller Bigfoot also.
Wow, I didn't know you had two.
So the proof is in the pudding. And the pudding is getting really good. But when I shot and killed one house out of San Antonio, the first one, I was using a 30-06, and the second one I shot the same night, and that also came from a 30-06.
Wow.
And the reason, or the way I captured them to kill them, was bear, a piece of ribs from Walmart, and some deer urine spread on the ribs.
Uh-huh.
And that is what attracted them. But what got me there was the homeless people. The homeless people no one would listen to, and everybody was saying there were two or three police reports made about Bigfoot dragging a thing across the road, and then another police report was made about Bigfoot coming in their camp and stealing stuff. And I know it sounds crazy, but I looked into it. And the more I looked into it, the more I realized that there was a family or a pod or whatever you want to call them of Bigfoot outside of San Antonio, Texas, harassing the homeless people.
Wow. And how long was, so nobody really believed the homeless people until you heard about it, or?
No one really believed the homeless people, period. There was a news story that made news where the homeless girl called 911, and or the couple called 911 about a Bigfoot dragging a dead deer across the road. And I have did documentaries about homeless and so on, and I can tell you that they don't like to get the police involved in any way.
Yeah.
And for them to call the police and report a Bigfoot, that is like, there's something there. They saw something. So that's how I came there and shot and killed two of them.
And they all in that same area. Now, one is 8 foot tall, is that it?
Correct. One is 8 foot tall, 4 foot wide.
Wow.
The other one is almost 5 foot tall and about 2.5 foot wide.
Okay. And you've been keeping them under, I guess, lock and key or ice or for the last, what, year and a half or so?
No ice. What happened was as soon as I shot and killed them, we transported them outside of Las Vegas, Nevada, and that's where they stayed for give or take 9 or 10 months, and then they were moved to North Washington State. And that's where I picked them up at.
Okay. And I, on the internet, I went on today, Rick, I pulled off pictures. Now, those are actual pictures of Bigfoot.
Correct.
Okay. Now, when you tell the story of how you got these, the Bigfoot, Rick, do a lot of people greet you like with a lot of skepticism, or?
Yeah, and the reason they do is because they didn't understand that I had a NDA that I had to follow. I couldn't tell the exact truth, but I did want people to know that that I did kill and would bring out to the world Bigfoot. And that's why I said some untruth, but I said that at the very beginning. At the very beginning, I told everyone. I said, what I'm about to tell you, you will hear some lies, you will hear some truth, but at the end of the day, there will be a dead Bigfoot. And I couldn't come out and say, hey, the Bigfoot's 8 foot tall, 4 foot wide, was the first one, and then the second one is this and that, and here's how I killed them, and this and that. I couldn't do that. So I had to not break my NDA. So instead of telling people, hey, it's 8 foot tall, I told people it's 8 foot eight. I told people 800 pounds. To not break my NDA. It was on the borderline of breaking my NDA, but I just couldn't do it.
Mm-hmm. Now, some people asked you, Rick, why you couldn't capture him alive?
It was a money issue. There is a lot of money involved in capturing a dead one. And just think of capturing a live one. It's just so much money involved in that. So
yeah,
that's out of the question unless any of your listeners want to give me some money and then I go capture a live one. But that's not going to happen.
Mm-hmm. Now you still feel there's more Bigfoot in that area where you killed these two?
Absolutely, there's more. There is a lot more. That area, if you look at it from Google Maps. And if you walk it like I did, it leads back into a forest and then a big lake, and behind that leads all the way up to the next state, and that's hundreds of miles of forest. So at night you can cross roads without being seen. So that's how they travel. And I think that it is some kind of migration route. I'm not sure, but that's just my opinion.
Now, Rick, is that's also on your website. I pulled one where you're standing with your thumb up, and there's a trail going up through the mountains and woods, and there's another gentleman up on a trail. Is that the area you're referring to?
No, that there is... Mount Charleston, and the person in the back is Craig Phillips, my security.
Okay, but that's not the spot where you got the two Bigfoot.
No, it's not. But we are going to stop by there and take some more photos and do a reenactment and everything when we pass through San Antonio, Texas, in about 2 weeks.
Okay. Rick, Walter, we got some callers on the line, but also we're going to be giving away some CDs. Is that correct?
Yeah, we got some CDs here signed and endorsed by Rick.
Bigfoot, Sasquatch,
and
Yeti in your neighborhood.
There you go, man.
Thanks, Rick. And we got your autograph on these, Rick, and we got callers. We're going to be giving them away today while you're on the air, Rick.
Okay, let's go ahead and take this call here. Hi, you're on the air with Rick Dyer.
Hello, I'm Kevin from Masontown.
Okay.
I've been on the air many times on WMBS. The reason I'm calling is that, yes, at one point in my life, I thought I saw a Bigfoot.
Okay.
What gets me is that there is somewhere different between man and ape and bear. The things that, you know, go on in the world.
Yeah.
But I saw what I thought was a man hunkered down alongside the road. And this was, like, 50 years ago. I slowed down and pulled over, and it stood up and looked at me, and it was a hairy beast.
Wow.
This was on right,
yeah,
on Route 21.
Well, you know, Fayette County is a hot spot for sightings of Bigfoot.
This was out by Springdale Golf Course.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know exactly.
That area.
Yeah.
I was coming back from Uniontown, heading back to Masontown. It was probably like, you know, 10, 11 o'clock at night. And I saw something on the side of the road. I thought it was a man hunkered down.
Mm-hmm.
And I slowed down as a courteous person, you know, to see,
yeah,
oh, man, somebody's in trouble. And when it actually stood up, it scared the crap out of me.
I bet it did.
It was a big, hairy beast.
Yeah.
And nope. I didn't even waste time. I just flew away.
Yeah. Now, Rick,
I punched it.
Rick, have you heard a lot of stories like this?
Oh, every single day. Every single day.
Rick, what I want to ask you as a caller, if Bigfoot really is the in-between of man and ape and, you know, progression as we all go, why have we not found more of that? Or are they that good at staying away from everything?
I don't believe that Bigfoot is in between man and ape. I believe that it's a new species all its own. This thing is a monster. The only thing that resembles a man is in our brain, we know how we walk upright.
Yes.
And we know
how
we
move.
As this
does also.
Correct.
I mean, you know.
But that's the only thing.
But, you know, the point being is, why is this thing so secretive that people don't see it all the time? Is this the quote-unquote missing link? Do you understand what I'm saying?
I completely understand what you're saying, and the reason why we don't see them or find them is because they don't want to be found. And the only reason I got these is because they got immune to the homeless people living in the woods.
Yes. Yes, I heard that earlier, and I was cooking my mom dinner, and I was doing some things, and I got a moment. I wanted to call in because it's like, wow, you know, being that I saw something, and I'm talking, like I said, this is 50 years ago, but for good Lord's sakes, I saw something that I could not explain, and I am a realist, and you have to show me. Actually, I should be from Missouri, right? You got to show me so I believe.
Yep.
And I don't believe it unless I see it. But I saw something that was so different than anything I had ever seen in my life, which is why I still believe. But the only thing I don't believe is, why in the heck are they so far away from us? Why do you not see more Bigfoot sightings, and why do you, of course, if you,
yeah,
as you say, they want to be secretive, they want to be in their own way, but still, I spent a lot of my career working as a surveyor and doing environmental work, and I was out in the field. I saw things in the woods that I never thought I'd see in my life, but you know what? I never saw a Bigfoot. Other than that one
right
night 50
road.
Years ago.
Yeah, it's usually how stuff like that happens. All of a sudden, you see something that when you try to find them or see them, you can't.
Yes.
Hey, yeah. Would you like?
Hey, listen. I'm gonna let you guys go. Thanks for letting me talk a little bit.
Would you like to have a CD of the Searching for Bigfoot
autographed and signed and endorsed by Rick Dyer?
Okay. What's your name?
My name is Kevin Spagen. Spaggen.
Okay, Kevin. I'll have a note on here on one of these CDs here at the WMBS.
You put that at the WMBS office, and
yes, sir.
I'll come in and see someone, whether it's Brian or Mike or
Boy, you know everybody
AM
here.
Or Kibby. You know, I know them all. I talk to all of these guys.
All right, Kevin. Thank
it's
you.
It's all way cool.
All right.
So, yes, I will.
Okay.
I'll talk to you, and thanks for your time.
All right, Kevin. Thank you.
Have a great day.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
All right, Rick, hey, we got to take a break here, Rick, so please stay with us. And listeners talking to Rick Dyer, the man who has shot Bigfoot, two of them, and we'll be starting on a tour here. That's what we're going to get into when we come back from this break, so please stay with us. And if you'd like to call in and ask Rick a question, 724-438-4593 is the number here, and we'll be right back.
Not a folklore and legend anymore. Out of a myth, the truth was born. King David used a stone between two sticks. A tracker used a 30-06. Rick calls him Hank from San Antonio. Is he Goliath? A monster? I don't know. 800 pounds and stands 8 foot tall. Rick Dyer shot him and watched him fall.
Okay, we are back, and Rick Dyer, he has to be the master Bigfoot tracker because he's the only one in the world that actually got two Bigfoot specimens and ready to go on tour starting in Phoenix, Arizona on Monday. And Rick, before we get into some more of your tour, we have a caller would like to speak with you. You're on the air with Rick Dyer.
Hey, this is Terry Corporal. Rick, I've been following this Bigfoot thing going on, and I know that there's been a lot of guys, you know, hunting Bigfoot, and there's been a lot of guys that say, you know, they saw Bigfoot. But I this is the first time, I mean, I've been listening, I always listen to Yinz's program, by the way, to WMBS. But anyway, I've never heard of anyone shooting one before, and you say, and this is the second time that you shot one. How can I see, is there a picture, what's the documentation? Like, you said you're going on tour, am I going to be able to see the, like, pictures, am I going to, like, how's it going to work? Like, what's my proof? Like, I'm interested.
I shot both of them the same night, so... There wasn't no days between them. What sort of documentation? Well, we have the Bigfoot bodies. We have the documentation, like a 3D imaging scan, is going to be on inside the trailer. And everyone else in the past 50, 60 years has given people blurry photos, blurry videos.
Yes, that's what I mean. That's what I said about it. I've seen it. You always see on TV, you see the blurry, the guy running with the night vision camera, and that blur going by it saying it's Bigfoot. And that's my question is to you is, like, do you have him? Like, you shot him, or do you, the body, you know, all that stuff. What's the deal?
I shot him. I have him. I'm not releasing blurry photos. I'm releasing crystal clear photos.
Okay, good. Yeah. When are you going to be on tour in Fayette County?
Well, if he would like to come to Fayette County, but he needs a $3,500 sponsor to get here. So if you know some people would like to sponsor Rick to bring Bigfoot here to Fayette County, give Walter Shrum a call. Walter, what's your phone number?
724-797-6352.
$3,500 will bring him here.
Were they
we are booked all the way up to Florida.
Were they male Bigfoots, female Bigfoots?
Two male Bigfoots.
Oh my goodness. I don't know. I want to see that. I'm just saying, I'm kind of a skeptic.
Well, go on his Rick Dyer's website. He has pictures up. You can take a look there. And also, would you like to have a CD?
Yes.
What's your name again?
Terry Carpel.
Okay. Hey, these are signed and endorsed by Rick Dyer.
Oh, I'd love it.
All right, Terry, I got your name on one. And go to Rick Dyer's website and check it out. And keep updated on his tour where he's going. And if you know somebody like to give $3,500 up, we'll get Rick when he's down in Florida to come up here to Fayette County.
How am I getting one of them CDs?
I'll have your name on it here at WMBS Studio.
Okay. Bigfoot, the two male Bigfoots. He is taking them on tour. Is that what he's saying?
You taking them both on tour, Rick?
Yes, I am taking the first one, the 8-foot one, on tour right now, and as soon as we get the second one, then the second one will be on tour. But both of them will not be in Phoenix, but they probably will be in Florida. So,
do they have human-like penises?
Yeah.
Is it like an ape?
You missed that one, Harry.
All right. Well, hey, we got to take our final break of this evening, so thanks for the call.
Okay, what about the balls?
Thanks for the call. All right.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Balls and penis.
Okay, let's go ahead and take a break. Okay, we are back here. Jack Evans with you, and on the line from Las Vegas, Nevada, Rick Dyer, and also in the studio, Walter Shrum, Harry Metz. Wrapping up the last few minutes of the first hour of the Jack Evans Show, but been pretty interesting. Rick Dyer claiming he has proof he's going to start a tour on Monday in Phoenix, Arizona, that he has Bigfoot, shot Bigfoot in San Antonio, Texas. Actually has two. One will be first one, the big one, 8-foot, will be on tour with him Monday. Then at some point he'll bring in the smaller Bigfoot, both males. And from what you were saying, Rick, you're going to be on Phoenix, Good Morning Phoenix, is that correct, on Monday?
Yeah, that's the schedule, I believe. I'm not too sure. Someone else makes my schedule and is in charge of it. I will be on a Phoenix news station in the morning.
Okay. And you've done six interviews already today.
I've done six interviews already today. People have flew in from China, from Japan, from Australia to do interviews with me, from Mexico. It's been awesome. It's been awesome. And I am the best Bigfoot tracker in the world. I have a bunch of jealous people that wants to be me. I have a bunch of jealous people that... don't have anything better to do with their life than harass me, but I'm okay with that too. Okay. So I'll just bring me attention.
Yeah. Hey, Rick, you've been nice enough. You're going to come back after 6 o'clock CBS News, which we're going to be getting into here real soon. So we appreciate that. We'll give you a call back about 10 after 6. And listeners, if you have some questions, maybe we come back after the CBS News. We'll talk a little bit more with Rick Dyer about Bigfoot. So please stay with us. And, Rick, we'll be giving you a call back around 10 after 6.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye. All right, and we'll get to callers a little bit later in the show when we come back, but very interesting, and once again, we will be back after the 6 o'clock CBS News with Rick Dyer, so you want to please stay with your local station, WMBS, and we have some CDs to give away, too. Searching for Bigfoot, written, sung by Walter Shrum and Jayme DeFilippo, so stay with us, WMBS, Uniontown. Okay, we're back here, Jack, with you, and with on the air with me is Rick Dyer, the Master Bigfoot Tracker. And once again, Rick, thank you so much for coming on the air with us.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, Rick, Walter's got some questions he wants to ask you, and go ahead, Walter.
Well, these are just for the views of our area, like stuff like, just to review it again, what kind of gun did you use to shoot these Bigfoots with, Rick?
A model 1730-06.
Wow. How many shots did it, you know, like, how many shots did it take on the on Hank to take Hank down?
3 shots.
How many on the other Bigfoot?
1.
Wow. And did when you shot them, Hank, was it like the third shot, like, was it, so the third shot had to be, the kill shot, that's what you're saying then, too. And it was still running while you shot it, I'm assuming, and then the kill shot would be the last shot then.
I mean, well, now I can tell the real story because my NDAs have dropped now. And what happened was I shot him one time when I was beside Morgan Matthews, and then I ran after him, and I shot him the second time. When I shot him the second time, he just stopped. Just came to a dead stop, and then that's when I shot him the third time, and that was the kill shot.
Wow. Okay.
And you want to talk about the film?
Hey, Rick, tell them about your film that these people don't know about. We don't know when it's coming in our area, the shooting Bigfoot. We don't know, you know, we know it was in Canada last or New York City, but, like, tell a little bit, like, about that film, if you could, or something, if you wanted to.
Shooting Bigfoot was filmed by the BBC, and it was a documentary, not a movie. And he followed a couple other Bigfoot hunters, and we was actually scheduled to film another 2 weeks, but when I shot and killed Bigfoot, the film just came to an abrupt end. You can see it. Hopefully at the Alamo Draft House Cinema, because that's where we will be touring across the country.
Do you think that film will ever come like this way anywhere? It was in New York City, right? You think it'll, like, what's it doing? Like, where, you know anything about it or anything? Or?
Yeah, just like I just said, we're trying to get it at the Alamo Draft House in Houston, San Antonio, Austin, and Katy, Texas. So we're trying our best to get it this month. So,
Hey, Rick, can you give us your the tour dates, where you're going to be across the country, and will people be able to go on your website and see the your tour dates and your stops?
Our tour dates are going to be posted on our website as they're needed. Dates will be posted also. So y'all are going to have to stay tuned for that. The only thing I can tell you that I have in front of my face is we will be in Phoenix, Arizona, on Monday, this coming up Monday.
Okay.
And the next day we will be in Flagstaff. The next day, Albuquerque, New Mexico. And that's as far as I know offhand. I know that we will be hitting Dallas, Houston, San Antonio, Lubbock, Oklahoma City, Tulsa. So I know that we'll be around there too.
Okay.
And we're zigzagging our way across the country to get to Florida. And the Florida is going to be the pinnacle of the tour, of the first leg.
Okay, and any listeners out there who like to, once Rick gets into Florida, he said $3,500 will get him up here to Fayette County. So if you'd like to maybe sponsor Rick and Bigfoot to get him up here, just give Walter Shrum a call.
724-797-6352.
Okay, and you'll handle it and get in touch with Rick.
Yes, I will.
Okay.
You know, if we probably gave a number out, some more people will call him.
724-438-4593 is the number here if you'd like to call and talk to Rick. We do have a caller here on the line right now. Let's go ahead and take that call. And you're on the air with Rick Dyer.
Hi.
Hi.
My question is, whenever you were, like, close to those things, did they have a smell? What did they smell like? And how are you keeping them from, like, rotting in the way, like, at this moment?
I heard the first question.
She asked, did they smell, and how are you keeping the bodies from rotting?
Okay, the first question, how do they smell? To be perfectly honest, we didn't smell anything at all. So all the stories that Sasquatch gives off, this smell and stuff, I can't verify that because these two Sasquatches never gave off a smell. Was it because they was comfortable, or was it because they just don't give off smells? So that I don't know. The other question was, how do we keep it from rotting? The large Bigfoot is taxidermied. The university did an autopsy and did all the medical tests. And then after that, I had it mounted or taxidermied. I mean, whichever one that you want to use, it needs the same thing, I guess. And that's how we can take it across the country, the world, to show it to everyone. It is real skin, real Bigfoot skin. It is, I didn't want nothing fake to be put on this. And the regular taxidermies will put in glass eyeballs and fake teeth and clean it up. And I just didn't want that for this Bigfoot. I wanted it to look as natural as possible. And a lot of people are saying, well, that don't look like Bigfoot. And my answer to that is, you probably never seen a real Bigfoot. Every photo, every picture is blurry. I didn't want to do that. I released a clear image of Bigfoot, clear video of Bigfoot. It's 2014. There's no excuse for blurry stuff anymore. I'm setting the standard. Everybody that wants to know about a Bigfoot now has to come to Rick Dyer, the best Bigfoot tracker in the world.
All right. Caller, would you like to have a CD?
Yes. Very interesting.
Okay, what is your name, caller?
Denise Schufert.
Okay, Denise, I'll put your name on a CD and you can pick it up here at the studio.
You know what? I'm wondering, he knows without a doubt what he has. So how does he feel when somebody comes up in his face and call him a liar, even when they're looking at it? And for real, they don't know what they're looking at anyways because they've never seen one before.
Right. Do you know what I mean? Exactly.
Right.
But the funny part, ma'am, is that everyone who has seen it in person, everyone says it's real.
everyone are the haters or the people who don't like me that has seen photos. It can't be real because they don't even believe in Bigfoot. So that really don't bother me at all. But I have never had anyone look at this specimen and said, oh, this not real. I've never had one person. And shoot, I bet you over 2,000 people has seen it since I started to show it. And not one person said, oh, that's fake.
All right. Thanks, Denise.
Very interesting. Very interesting.
Okay. Thank you, Denise.
All righty.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right. We got another caller. Rick, we're going to take that. And you're on the air. Rick Dyer.
Hello, Rick. My name is Bill R. Galbraith, and I just turned on WMBS and caught the tail end of the news, and I decided to listen further, and I'm glad I did. I'd like to know where you shot these two creatures and when.
I shot them outside of San Antonio, Texas on September 6th of 2012, and they have been at a university ever since.
Did it make the newspapers and television and that?
Yes, I am everywhere right now. I just did 6 interviews today.
No, I mean whenever you shot them, shortly after that, did it make the newspapers and news?
Oh, absolutely not, because we had to keep it secret.
Why is that, Rick?
Because I didn't want the government to come in and take my body. And that's why what happened was after I shot and killed it, we loaded them up in back of a freezer truck, and there was a lot of wow, because we really didn't know what to do, because we didn't want the government to take it. We did not want the fish and game to take it. So what we did was they had all this on film, so the film people went directly back to the UK. The people who had some more footage went the opposite way, so we could prove this without a doubt. And then we called a government agency and had them come out. And we met the government agency at a university in Texas. And when we got there, they came in the truck, they walked around it, they took a hair sample, they took a skin sample, and they took a saliva swab in his mouth. And then she looked at me and she said, well, congratulations, it's not human. I can tell you that. And said, if anything else, we will get back in touch with you. So that those words, get back in touch, we did not like at all. So we wanted to study it all we could, and that's why we send it to the university. And this was very secretive. Mm-hmm. And they did all their tests and stuff. And then we had it taxidermied. Mm-hmm. And it looks like we are safe and clear now of anybody taking this body here.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that was one. When did you shoot and kill the other one?
The same night.
Same night.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think there is a possibility that there's others?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. I know for a fact there's others, because one other one attacked the cameraman that was there. Mm-hmm.
and all this is on the film documentary Shooting Bigfoot.
Well, okay, that's all the questions I have.
All right, Phil, would you like to have the CD Searching for Bigfoot signed by Rick Dyer?
Yes, sir, I would.
All right, Phil, I'll put your name on it, and you can pick it up here at WMBS.
Okay, thanks a lot.
All right, Phil, good night.
Nice talking to you.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Phil.
All right, Rick, hey, we got to take a break here, Rick, so can you hang with us a little bit longer?
Sure can.
Okay, we'll be right back, listeners, and the number here is 724-438-4593 if you'd like to call in and talk with Rick. We'll be right back.
Un, deux, trois, quatre.
Okay, Zooby Zooby Zoo, Jack Evans here. We're back with you. Wow, what a fantastic evening this is with Rick Dyer on a line calling from Las Vegas, Nevada, where my sister and brother-in-law lives, and talking about the two Bigfoots that Rick killed down in Texas. Going to take them on tour here. Starting on Monday, he's going to be in Phoenix, Arizona on a TV morning show. Don't know if we can pick that up here. I don't know how we do that. Maybe if you got satellite TV, huh?
Or is it live stream? Do they do internet?
Yeah, they do.
I'm sure it'll be reposted.
Yeah, reposted. And then you're off and running, Rick.
Off and running. And our first leg ends in Daytona Beach. And then we start from Daytona Beach. We're going to go up the coast for our second leg and zigzag across the country.
Okay, well, maybe by then Walter Shrum will have lined up, when you're in Florida, a sponsor to get you up here to Fayette County. Only $3,500 will get you up here with Bigfoot, which would be really a big thrill, huh, Walter?
Yes, that would be.
Wow.
Now, your sister and brother-in-law live out by where Rick does. Couldn't they go see it?
Well, they have to go to Phoenix, I guess.
Well, I don't know. He's touring around. Where's he start? He's starting out in
Phoenix.
Phoenix?
Yeah, you're starting in Phoenix, right, Rick?
Yeah, starting in Phoenix and then going to Flagstaff and Albuquerque and Amarillo, and then we're going to zigzag from there.
Hey, Rick, how did you become a Bigfoot tracker? Was it something like that first caller we had that was going down the road and saw something, jumped out? Is that what happened to you, or how did you get all interested in this?
Me and my buddy was hiking through the woods in 2008, and we came across a dead Bigfoot that was laying beside a stream. And we dragged him out of the woods. We made a bunch of YouTube videos that we had a Bigfoot, and we was excited and all this mess, and then we got a knock at the door that demanded, without a warrant, that demanded to see the dead Bigfoot. We showed it to them, and then they confiscated it, and they took all our pictures, our videos, and everything.
Wow.
Who's they, Rick?
The government.
Yes, the government.
Okay.
And we were so deep in this so far, so we had to do something, and that's why we made up a fake one. And that is known as the 2008 Bigfoot on Ice or Freezer.
Yeah, I do. I remember seeing that on the internet.
And I got so depressed because of that, because we knew we had one, and now people say, oh, he's a hoaxer now. So I just wanted to redeem myself, and that's why I made it my mission to find a Bigfoot. And God helped me, and he helped me find two.
Wow.
So I'm happy.
Rick, we have another caller here. Let's go ahead and take that call. Hi, you're on the air with Rick Dyer.
Hello?
Yes, you're on the air.
Hi, my name's Elizabeth. Hi, Rick.
Hey, how you doing, Elizabeth?
I'm doing okay. I have some questions, and I'm hoping you'll be able to answer some of them. Do you think that the Bigfoot species is something evil, or is it just an animal?
I believe that it could be evil. Now, I'm not saying that it's an alien or it's a ghost or anything like that. It's real and it has flesh, and you can touch it and you can feel it. But it can be evil, and I believe that they have killed humans before. There's a book called I can't remember the book's name. I think it's called The 411 or something. And he investigates people that went missing from national parks, and he believes that Bigfoot got them and killed them. And they never found the bodies or anything. So I know it sounds crazy, but when I heard it the first time, I thought, oh my God, this guy needs some help. But then after I killed one and saw what they could do, then I'm kind of leaning towards that way.
Yeah. Well, you said you're going to be returning to the site. Are you a little concerned about there being the rest of the clan or the family there? Especially if you're taking Hank with you?
That is a possibility, and we're always prepared for that possibility.
Okay. Now, within the guidelines of what you're willing to share, what's the most fantastic thing that you found out about this?
The most fantastic thing, I tell you, and I'm going to reveal something now that I've never have done before. But I just can't get it out of my mind. I saw with my own eyes after I shot him, and he was dead for a couple of hours. It was like the wounds was trying to regenerate themselves, was trying to heal themselves. So, and it sounds crazy, I know, but like if we break a bone or if we get a cut, we heal ourselves, but it could take weeks or days. This was doing it almost instantly, like before your eyes, and this was after he was dead and not breathing, So I thought that was amazing.
Yeah, that would be. That definitely would be. Another question that I had is, you're going to be taking him through different states. Are you concerned about, how whenever you take animals or vegetables or whatever through different states? My concern is that one of these different states is going to decide that they're going to confiscate him.
No, we actually checked with all the states, and they've had no problem with us coming through their state. The only state that we might have a problem is California, because they stop and they check for fruits and stuff. Every border of California, but as far as being it confiscated, there's no worry from our end.
That's good. Do you have any idea where they came from? Do you have any ideas? Just personal ideas?
I think they have been around for just as long as we have, but I don't think that they're connected to men. But I don't know where they came from. God.
All right, Elizabeth, thank you so much for calling in. Would you like are you here locally, Elizabeth, that you can pick up a CD, or are you out of the area?
I'm closer to the Pittsburgh area.
Okay. All right.
I do want to say one thing. I think it's time to believe.
Thank you.
Okay, Elizabeth. Thank you so much. All right. Good night.
Good night.
All right. We got the time for one more call here. Hi, you're on here with Rick Dyer.
Hello, Rick Dyer. This is Bill R. Galbraith calling back for the second time. Do you have any intentions of going back to about the same area where you killed those two big feet in the upcoming future of maybe trying to capture them somehow in a trap? Like, maybe a rope? And then a nice thick bull rope.
I don't think a rope would work.
Yes, I'm planning to go back, and yes, I'm going to capture one alive. And I'm working with some people now that are wanting to support me on doing that. But yes, we are going back there. In fact, we will be back there in the near future this month to do some reenactments on film. But as far as us capturing one, it's probably going to be after the tour. But we're definitely going to capture one.
Probably about around the same area.
Yes, sir.
Where you shot the other two. Okay, yes. That's all I have, and thank you.
All right. Well, thanks, Phil. Have a nice evening.
Thank you.
And I would like to add that if people go to Facebook.com and put Rick Dyer Official is my fan page, I've got about 5,000 likes now. Mm-hmm. And on that fan page, you can follow me on the tour. Like, we will be making videos and posting pictures every day. So it's going to be cool. Rick Dyer Official fan page.
That's very interesting and very different.
Okay. Thanks, Phil.
Thank you. Bye.
Hey, Rick, what's this challenge you have with Dean Cain? The actor, Dean Cain.
Dean Cain has a TV show called Bigfoot Downey, and on his show, I was asked to be on that show, and I turned it down. And it's a bunch of people who really don't believe in Bigfoot, people that would rather try to look good on TV, like Ro Shaheeb and Justin Smeha, is just a Fruit Loop, and just a bunch of clowns. And they know they're not going to capture Bigfoot, and they're offering $10 million to do so. And, well, that's an easy bet. I bet on them not finding them. That's for dang sure. So I contacted Dean Cain, and I said, I want my $10 million. You come down here, and you bring your doctors, and you analyze this here. And then after it's proven real, I want my $10 million. And he has responded. And he responded with, oh, that was just for the show. Huh. If you were on the show and you found the evidence of Bigfoot while you were on the show, then we would pay you your $10 million. And I'm like, well, y'all are going to a cabin with 20 other people, and y'all are telling, okay, go find evidence of Bigfoot here. You just can't do that. It's a BS show. And I've got the real deal. If anybody wants to see the real deal, come and look at it, because we will be in a town near you very shortly.
Well, once again, Rick, if we could get you here to Fayette County, we could put Harry Metz right next to Bigfoot, and people may maybe confuse which is really Bigfoot.
Yeah, but he has to take his shirt off, Jack. You got to take his shirt off.
I am kind of fuzzy.
He's kind of fuzzy. Well, Rick, certainly you're going to be under a lot of scrutiny here in the following weeks and months, and Hope you got some broad shoulders, and I'm sure you do. You've gone through this somewhat before, so we'll keep our eyes and ears posted to see how things are going, and maybe a little bit later on in the tour we can hook up with you and see how things are going.
Well, it's not scrutiny, and it's not going to be hard on me because I'm telling the truth. So when you're telling the truth, you have nothing to worry about. I appreciate you letting me on your show, and I appreciate Walter Shrum. I love his music, and Walter, you're able to ride my coattails, then hop on it and let's go for a ride.
Let's go for a ride, Rick. Huh?
Hell yeah.
Thanks, Rick. I really appreciate you calling in tonight.
All right, Rick. Good luck to you, and we'll keep the eye on the news.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
All right. Good night. Bye-bye. All right, well, Walter Shrum, Harry Metz, that was really very interesting, very interesting show, and I guess we'll really start to maybe find out on Monday, huh?
Right,
yeah, that's cool. Yeah.
I just want to say anyone that can tolerate Walter for a year and a half and still have all their sanity is a great person, I guess. I've been putting up with him longer. I went insane long ago.
Well, listeners, Walter Shrum is the gentleman who wrote, and I think along with
Jayme DeFilippo.
Jayme DeFilippo, the good old boy. And also you wrote the other one, too, with the lady singer.
With the lady. Yeah, what was that called? I can't remember what
just
it was
called. Just WMBS.
WMBS.
Yeah, Listen in Style, Don't Touch That
Dial.
Yeah,
Don't Touch That Dial.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, so... But hey, anyway, we're going to wrap it up here. Thanks so much to Walter Shrum. Harry Metz. Harry, you're going to put this on YouTube?
Yeah, it'll probably be a week or two. I have some other projects ahead of it, but it'll probably be a week or two.
Okay, so how would somebody want to go and see what occurred here this evening?
Well, it'll be listed under the Jack Evans Show with Rick Dyer. That'll be the title. So all they have to do probably in a week or two here is type in on YouTube. They have that little toolbar at the top, and you type in... The Jack Evans Show with Rick Dyer, and that'll pop up.
Okay.
Can I give my website?
Yeah, go ahead.
www.walterstrum.com, and you can buy a CD right off my website.
Okay. And hopefully tomorrow I have scheduled a lady by the name of Jade Mills. She's a real estate agent out in California. She is selling Bob Hope's home. So I hope to have her on tomorrow evening to talk about Bob Hope's home, which is like about 15,000 square feet.
Wow.
So that should be interesting. Okay, stay tuned for high school basketball coming up here on WMBS. Yeah.